A camera, a degree, and a passion for dance. Three things I had when I finished university. Stepping into the world unknown, I was looking for a career that could probably entail all three. However, I wasn't lucky enough. 2007 gave me my dream job, brand manager for Givenchy in Sri Lanka. 2008 paved a career in dance for me. And 2009, my first photography exhibition. Having had the best of all three, I realized that there was so much more out there for me than what I was settling for. It's been 5 years since dance has transformed me, sufficient time to have found some amazing individuals to form my very own dance team, the ImzyS. Okay. These individuals not only conform to dance, but so much more. There's something about them that makes them do more, care, share, and a whole lot more. During this time, I also met a very special individual, a lady, who realized my talents and my skill and my ability to dance, and also to share it with everyone else. Quoting her right now, she said, "Imran, if you can make me dance, you can make anyone dance." So, having said that, she opened a great avenue for me, which I probably never would have thought of. It was an opportunity far beyond realization or explanation. She said, "Imran, would you like to work with children with special needs?" Shocked I was, initially, of course, because I had no experience whatsoever of working with children with disabilities or special needs. So I said, "Fine, let me take on this challenge, and let's see." My topic today, what I had mentioned, is where there's a heartbeat, there's a rhythm. I can assure you, everyone here, that I can make you dance. Why? Because all of you have a heartbeat. But then I wondered, can I apply the same thing with these children? I gave it some thought, and then yes, I was like, fine, this is where my calling is, and I'm going to do this. So, I took on this opportunity at the Chitralen School in Colombo, a well-known resource center for children with special needs. 3 months of training these children with the assistance of my hand-picked individuals, who I call the ImzyS. It was difficult when we went in initially, obviously, of the barriers of being able to speak to them, understand, and a lot of other things. With the assistance of the school, it worked really well. And first lesson was a bit difficult, second, a little more, but then they got into the swing of things. That's the dance team. These are some amazing kids that I've worked with at the Chitralen School. And these children had the ability to dance. This is me with them just before a performance that they had. I was shocked. So coming to how this whole realization process came about was the first few times we tried asking them to copy us, and then even if I told them, okay, your right hand up, I was just the mirror image for them, and they would lift their left hand up. So I'd have the same issue, or even if I was to turn my back, they wouldn't follow properly. So it did take me a lot of time, not only that, but to kind of instill rhythm. I realized, yes, these children have a heartbeat, so I'm sure they can find rhythm. Let me ask all of you to do a small exercise with me. Rhythm is something that we all have on a day-to-day basis. The way we talk, the way we walk, the way we write, all of it has rhythm. So let me loosen you up a bit today, and let's try this little exercise that I have for you, right? You don't need to stand up. You don't need to stand up. You just need to join in. That's it. Hands up. sit out. Okay, I'm just gonna get you to do this beat for me. I have my dancers around to help you and assist you, right? So they're gonna do this for you as well. So, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Now, together, right? Stop. Very good. Now, that is all of y'all clapping to a rhythm, right? So basically, this is something I know that I can do with anyone who's here. And then, again, when I took on the challenge, I tried this with those kids. It didn't work. Obviously, I had to do other things. It's just that I had to just kneel with the child, keep the child on my lap, and just bounce the rhythm. That's it, just the beat, just so that they would feel it. Right? That's one of the things. I'm not going to tell you everything, so then you probably know how to do what I do better than me. So this is something that actually worked with these kids. It's about being able to listen to the music and sit on that lap and you give them that beat. Right? By the way, this exercise, we're going to do it much later when my crew and I will perform just a small dance kit for you. So coming into this whole concept of having worked with children was beyond imagination for me. I never thought this would be something that I would go into. The other thing I'd like to bring to everyone's attention, I'm a Muslim. Dance is something that doesn't come that easy. And especially when you're born into a conservative family, where they're like, dance, no. So I realized that I just couldn't, like, suppress myself. Everywhere I went, I walked, I was at a wedding or a party, whatever it was, I just kept moving. And my dad, who's also here in the audience, would always be like, stop that. So I've been through this whole process of having to, you know, have that little nudge, stop it, stop it, stop it. So then I realized, okay, I need to be able to keep my parents happy, the community happy, and also be able to dance. So I realized working with children with special needs could probably be like something I'm giving back to the community. These are some of the kids I've worked with. They're amazing children. The next time you look at them, don't treat them differently. They're just like you and I. Accept them, love them, and feel from within. These kids are like us. They can move like us. It's just that at times when we put them all into one segregated side, you're like, oh, that's what they're good at. Or maybe they wouldn't probably be able to be like us. Like the speech you saw much earlier on. Medication and then be at home. Or be a star. This is, again, I worked with some of the children at a home. The Shilpa girls' home. These girls are, I wouldn't know how to explain it, but their talents are just perfect. I think it's mind-blowing that I was given the opportunity and chance to work with such children and to be able to instill something that I call my own. Having said that, I decided, fine, this lady gave me this opportunity, I worked with all of these children, superb. Now, let me start my own class. So with the help of one of my fellow members of the dance crew, a speech and language therapist by profession, we started our own dance class for children with special needs. I wish the frame was a little higher, but we started our own class. And it's been amazing. We've had this one child. She's been with us for about 8 months. And for the first 7 months, all she did in the class was that. That's all she did. She had her corner, she didn't move. But then I realized, this is my challenge, I'm gonna make this kid dance. I'm gonna do it somehow. And I told their parents, make sure she keeps coming. And they did just that. So now, exactly now it's been seven and a half. She actually dances. So for the first 6 months, she stood in a corner, she watched every single move, studied our moves, though she didn't dance and show it to us. But then, now, she's the only one who keeps dancing through the whole class. That was amazing. Dance is not just for me. Dance is for everyone. I'm not asking you to become a dancer. There are finer details of being able to dance. You can be so flexible. You boost your self-confidence, your inner self. You're stronger to face challenges, obstacles. That's what dance can do to you. Then I worked with the patients with Alzheimer's at the center. Again, you can't see most of it. These patients, okay, this is a really funny one. They obviously forget. So every time they danced, they sat back in their chair and they're like, what are we seated for? I said, dance. We're going to dance. And then they got up again and they started moving and I was like, we just danced. They sat again and it happened 4 times, to be precise. And then I was tired, they weren't. So it's been really nice that I've been able to share this magic of being able to instill rhythm and dance in such amazing people. And there's some pictures of it. Dance is the mere reason that I'm here before you today to speak to you and tell you what dance has done differently for me, how dance has changed my life and the people around me, and the way I have been able to take dance forward here. I'm going to leave you with this. Dancing with your feet is one thing. Dancing with your heart is another. Loosen yourselves a bit and let's embrace dance. There's a performance.
खामों का थामा का जो डहता